What's up, you guys? It's Karla here, and I am back with another video. As I said in my previous video, do not mind that little stain on my shirt. It is just olive oil. I literally just got done filming a video right before this one about my everyday mom makeup routine. If you're interested in that video, go ahead and check it out. And this video is going to be about my hair, about my twist out. As you can see, my hair are in single twists. They aren't mini twists, they're just like medium-sized twists. And I'm going to tell you the products that I use this time to achieve my twist outs. And at the end of this video, I'm going to take my hair down so that you can see my hair in a twist out. So I'm going to show you the products that I use, and I hope that it helps you when you do your twist outs. So I haven't had heat in my hair since 2014. Like, no, 2014 or 2015, whatever. I haven't had any heat in my hair. No flat ironing, no hot comb, no blow drying, curling irons, no heat. I haven't had any heat in my hair at all, and I love it that way. I don't know what texture my hair is, 4C, 4A, be whatever. I don't follow that. I have no clue what my hair type is. I just know that I have extremely dry hair. But if you want to know more about my hair and how I grew my hair out, please go ahead and check out my other video that I will link down below. And I think it's called How to Grow Natural Hair, or How I Grew My Natural Hair. And you'll see what I did to allow my hair to grow and be at its healthiest. So before I get into all the products, well, I'll just get into the products. So before I twisted my hair up, I use cheap conditioner. Right now, this is my favorite. It's been my favorite for about 2 years. It's the Herbal Essence Essences Hello Hydration Moisturizing Conditioner. I love this stuff so much. I love the smell of it. It gives my hair amazing slip. So when I'm detangling my hair, it doesn't give me any trouble. It actually helps me, you know, detangle. And I use a lot of conditioner when I'm co-washing my hair. I shampoo my hair once every 2 weeks. I find that conditioner is best for my hair. There's my daughter, Cunny. Say hey.
Hi.
So yeah, that's my daughter. So yeah, I find that co-washing my hair really leaves it very moisturized. So this time, this is what I use. I use any kind of cheapy conditioner. I don't really spend a lot of money on, you know, expensive conditioners. I use Herbal Essences and Suave and VO5. Cheapy conditioners. And I use a crap ton of them, so I have a lot of them at all times. And all of them are like less than $5. So yeah, I use this to co-wash my hair while I was in the shower. And after that, I section my hair into four big sections. So I just parted it down the middle, parted it down the side, and I worked section by section. And after I rinse the conditioner out, I use this as my leave-in. It's not a leave-in conditioner, it's the Palmer's. Hopefully you guys can. Okay, so after I use the hairdress, I follow up with an oil, and this, I have a bunch of different oils. But yeah, this is the oil of choice. Again, very cheapy, excuse the hair all over it. I use my products, like, I'm not trying to make it cute. This is what it looks like in my bathroom. But this is the Tropical Roots Growth Oil, and it says stimulating growth oil, new with pineapple and guava, lightweight, promotes healthy hair growth, and for all natural hairstyles. And I love the smell of it. It does smell like pineapple. And so I just spray this all over the section that I just finished doing the hairdress on. So yes, after I use my oil, I also follow up with a gel. Right now, my favorite gel is the Eco Style Gel, and this is the Black Castor and Flaxseed Oil that contains vitamin E, fiber, and omega-3s, and it is alcohol-free. So this is my favorite right now, and I only use a tiny, tiny, tiny bit of gel. I don't like using a lot of gel in my hair because I just don't like even though this doesn't give me a crunchy feeling, I just find that my hair is more soft without gel. And I like this one a lot because my hair maintains its softness even with this gel in it. So I really do love this oil. So after I put the oil in it, I literally separate, I take the one of the four sections and I take it piece by piece, and I detangle it one more time, and I might spray some more oil on it, and then I'll just twist it up into these size twists. not jumbo twists, they're like medium sized twists, and I do like two twists per section, or probably no, like more like three twists per section. I do this all over my head, and I do bobby pin them down at night before I put on my bonnet so that they won't be flying everywhere in the morning. So this is what they look like. Yep, this is it. And you guys, that's all I use for my twist outs. And before I take my hair down, I'm just gonna go back to refresh in what I do. So once again, while I'm in the shower, I co-wash with the conditioner, split up my hair and detangle with the conditioner, split my hair up into four sections. I work by section. I follow up the conditioner with a hairdress as my leave-in. Then I follow up with an oil. Then I follow up with a gel. And then I twist my hair up. And this is the result. I do have one more bobby pin in my hair. I just felt it. So yeah, I'm about to go ahead and take down my twist so that you can see what my twist out looks like. And as before I take down my twist, I do take the oil and spray it on my hair just to waken it up a little bit. See, this is why I always have like stains on my shirt, because I get dressed first and then I do my hair, knowing good and well that oil stains clothes, but whatever. And I'm trying to hurry up because my battery is about to go dead, so I'm gonna zoom in so that you can see. And I just unravel my twist like that very carefully, because I don't want to mess up my curl pattern. And I just separate them about 2 to 3 times. Sometimes just, you know, I separate each section like 2 times so that the twist out can last longer. And that is what it looks like when I take down one twist. See? So I'm gonna go ahead and take down the rest of my twist, and then I'll be back to show you what it looks like. Okay, you guys, so this is what my hair looks like after I completely took down all of my twists. So now what I'm going to do is take my trusty pick and pick out my roots. Do not take the pick all the way through your hair, because you will completely destroy the twist out. So I'm sorry I keep looking at the viewfinder, but I'm just going to pick out my roots, and then I'm going to show you how it looks after I fluff my hair all out and stuff. Okay, so this is my hair after I picked out my roots and fluffed it out a little bit and played with it. Look at how much body is in my hair. Yes! So yeah, I'm very, very pleased about how this twist out turned out. And I hope this helped you guys. I have my little piece hanging down in the front. Gotta try to pose for the thumbnail. Yes! But yeah, and my hair smells amazing. I showed you guys what products that I use, and I really, really do hope that this video helped you guys. I always buy drugstore products. It is very rare. I don't think I've ever bought an expensive, like, high-end hair product. It's always drugstore. Target, Walmart, CVS, Walgreens. You know, that's just how I roll. If it works for my hair, I don't care how cheap it is, I'm gonna buy it. So let me know if this video was helpful to you guys in the comments below, and let me know what videos that you want to see from me. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up, give it a share, subscribe, and press that little bell so that you can be notified of all of my videos. Like, seriously, I'm gonna start popping these videos out, so please subscribe and let me know what you want to see on my channel. And thank you guys so much for watching. Please check out my other videos and be on the lookout for my next one. Peace.